cultural and religious beliefs go hand in hand. One example of culture is the ideas, customs, and social behavior of a particular people or society. Religion means a particular system of faith and worship. My name is Aliyah Petra, 18 years old, representing Kumato in the Miss Teen Awareness 2019 pageant. My video today focuses on religious and cultural beliefs of suicide. Since being chosen as a delegate, I have been led down the path of investigating not only the surface of suicide, but the depths of this sad and crucial issue. As an individual, I've personally been touched, and even though it still hurts, I have now begun to understand some of the thought processes that may lead a person down this path. My aims and goals have now been cemented, and I have decided that definitely continuing to be a suicide awareness ambassador is at the top of my agenda. Being an ambassador and Miss Teen Awareness would allow me to obtain my vision of educating individuals about mental health and depression. Interacting with family members of suicide victims and survivors, giving the wider society a better understanding of the effects, and hoping one day to have an NGO where young people can receive counseling, advice, self-esteem classes, and mental health tips. The Keelan Childs Foundation.
The cultural aspect of suicide and its beliefs show that suicidal behaviors often arise from lack of support from family members and the type of society the victim lives in. Although there are many services available, such as crisis hotlines, therapists, support groups, and much more, the decision to seek help can be influenced by a person's cultural background. An article shows that persons between the ages of 15 to 34 living in areas where impoverished had an increased rate of suicide compared to those living in suburban areas. Prolonged stress can exacerbate existing depression or arise a depressive episode to persons who have reached their wits' end.
Some cultures brush off symptoms of depression and consider them as a weakness or moral failure. Persons actively involved in change are at a lower risk of suicide because they tend to feel less hopelessness and reported more reasons for wanting to live than those who are not involved in religion. Mental health activists and religious leaders are very concerned about suicide because it has been growing in rates, and they believe a person experiencing suicidal thoughts should have three things to leave that dark state of life, which is involvement, commitment, and a belief system. Persons involved in after-school activities, churches, and attempt to stay close with their parents have less feelings of hopelessness. They will have more of a reason to live.
Religious and cultural beliefs go hand in hand, as it all depends on the beliefs and pressures of society that depend on the decision of a person regarding their perspective of a situation such as depression and mental health as a whole. Society needs to open up their eyes to the very real issue of suicide and remove not only the stigma attached to it, and understand that depression is a long process before someone ultimately decides to end their life. In the month of March 2019, I was personally touched with the loss of my close friend. He chose to end his life prematurely. As difficult as it is to share, I would like to let persons who are battling and suffering with suicidal thoughts understand the hurt and anguish left behind. No one saw behind the smiles and joy, nor could we have ever understood the deliberation that would have been going through his mind. The feeling that society would have failed him, and even religion. I can only hope that he left with us, his friends and family, a reminder to take time to communicate, show love and understanding to persons we are close to. As a suicide awareness ambassador, the decision is ultimately yours. You decide, not suicide.
Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon.